that is undying, that has always been and always will be. When one realizes one's immortal nature, one also begins to realize that this immortal nature, this eternal consciousness, that is your own aware witnessship, your seer, that has experienced your life, is the same consciousness as that which experiences all existence. So the Atman, the seer, the witnessing entity of your existence, is the same as the Paramatma, that witnessing entity of all existence. So if one wants to have dharma, one must come to this stage of one's existence where one realizes there is more to one's life than the simple pleasures and personal accomplishments, that one has a higher sense of purpose and an association with the great. When there is dharma, then community, the nature of community changes. People have always lived in community, in the tribes and clans and families. From the earliest peoples, they gather together for their safety, for their protection, for their well-being. It is in your genetic disposition. This has been the nature of people, to seek each other out. And in the shelter of their community, to find safety. But if one is following dharma and seeking truth, then what community one surrounds oneself with becomes very important. The nature of the community is extremely important. One will want to have a community that constitutes a sangha. That is a community that is dedicated to the same journey that you are on, the journey towards the divine, towards wholeness, towards eternal truth. So one will want to find this sangha, this community of like-minded individuals to support one in one's journey of life. Otherwise, it is very difficult. The Buddha gave three primary components of spiritual life and personal development. The first is dharma. The second, sangha, and the third, the Buddha, the enlightened one. So you need that spiritual community, or sangha, dharma, the way, and you need the goal, and the blessing of the enlightened one. That is the three great gifts of the spiritual path. So when you are talking about building community, sustainable community, it is not merely building community, a group of people. Really, it is not that hard to find a group of people to be with, but developing groupings of people in your personal efforts to go deep within yourself and to find the well of truth and wisdom within you, to find your inner connectedness where all the truth, all the wisdom, all the light of the universe exists, for it exists within you, within each of you. This potentiality lies within you. But to walk that inner path, you need dharma. Part of dharma is proper spiritual practice. You need proper training, proper technique to move towards the truth. You need proper understanding for the mind. You need teaching. And you need teachers. So the Sangha you want to create, the community, the sustainable community, is that which will sustain your spiritual life. Sustain your efforts to realize the great, so that you do not become dissipated in the collective desires of others whom you have surrounded yourself with, who have perhaps other intentions. So this is the support, and it is very, very important, this development of Sangha and community. Very important. And the more people move in this way of truthfulness towards this inner association and connectedness, the more they move in harmony with the universe, the more the society will take vitality and health again, and a bright light will be there in the world. So you be the harbingers, you be the people that bring this light into the world at this time, and use these three great gifts, dharma, sangha, and the enlightened teachings, the enlightened teachers. Use these gifts to bring dharma into the world. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
Very good.
Thank you.